orchestrally. How does this work with the police? I've seen other orchestral versions of music. Some are good, some are kind of shaky. How does it work with the police music?
What I think makes my work stand out is the disrespect that I bring to the party. Great love and admiration for my colleagues and the songs that Sting wrote and everything like that, but complete abandon when it comes to messing with it. When you hire somebody to orchestrate Elton John or something, they're going to go the straight and narrow because they don't want to. They don't want to upset the apple cart. But in this case, I have taken wild liberties with love and admiration in my heart. I have carved the songs up. They're still totally recognizable, but I've found obscure guitar lines, other vocal approaches that I've, because I got the multi-tracks out and I found all these other versions of things. And I got these live recordings where we improvised on stage. So all the stuff, that's my alarm, go away. Damn, where'd you go?
I'm
There you
here.
are.
I'm here.
So I found the multi-tracks with all these other approaches and live performances with strange extrapolations and improvisations, and I cut them in. I used all these ideas. So it's all full-on police stuff, but I have had a little more liberty than a hired gun to mess with it. And I think that is a little fresher than people who are too respectful, people who are, don't want to upset it.
Are you familiar with the Rochester Philharmonic Orchestra at all?
I am not. I assume with the Eastman School of Music nearby that it's going to have some hot players.
So you say you can just walk in on 2 o'clock, drop the score down there, 7:30, you're playing it
That's right.
because these guys are pros.
That's right. It's
And
quite miraculous. And I bring three soul sisters who are going to actually sing the songs, and which has opened up a whole new love affair with me and the Supremes, the Chiffons, the Ronettes, these women groups. I just love it. It's such a cool sound. And they have charisma out to here. But I also bring along guitar and bass, electric guitar and bass. And these guys are rock and rollers. And the interface between the rock guys and the orchestra guys is always interesting. They've got it now, but I mean, I divide musicians into two huge categories with only a little bit of overlap: the musicians of the ear and musicians of the eye. Now, my guys are all musicians of the ear. We s stare off into space while our ears connect with the music. Those orcs, they are musicians of the eye. The eye connects with the music that's on the page, and they connect with the music visually. Even the conductor's baton, which shows them where the beat is, that's a visual cue. So bringing my rock and roll guys into that world is always interesting. And actually, they discover that we are all fellow musicians. Those guys sitting at the back up there, those woodwinds looking, kind of fierce and slightly disapproving, they're easy to warm up. They are brothers and sisters, musicians. And I always enjoy breaking the ice in that way.